This will be a possibly a controversial or scandalous video and its topic for a decent amount of people, maybe. But we're going to talk about the extreme similarities between religion and science. You see, most people pick one or the other. Naive or desperate people usually choose religion, and atheists or materialists usually choose science, right? But I'm here to tell you, and I don't mean to insult anybody, okay? I have to make this disclaimer every video. This is not meant to offend anybody. This is about telling the truth, you see, because I don't accept bullshit. I smell bullshit from a mile away, and I cannot stand hypocrisy of any kind, okay? I'm done with that bullshit, right? You see, because I like to analyze something from every fucking angle possible, from every perspective. I love to have a universal perception as wide as possible, right? And I like to envision myself in somebody else's shoes so I can see myself from the religious and from the scientific aspect, you see? Because I haven't chosen one or the other because I can see all of their flaws, okay? But here is the evidence that I'm gonna present to you. Science and religion, they're more similar than you can even imagine, okay? First of all, they are both cults, okay? You need to understand this. It doesn't take a genius to understand that both science and religion are cults. Yes, for religion, it is obvious, but most people don't seem to realize this, that both, as well, the science community or the science echelon or whatever you want to call it, science has also been turned into a sort of cult, okay? And as any cult, it has its share of mindless followers, okay? Just like any religion, science, being extremely frigid, stubborn, simple-minded, and also afraid of possibilities that they haven't considered, right? Science also denies, rejects, and even deletes certain information or discoveries that might contradict certain conclusions regarding any branch of science. It is obvious, right? We both know how sensitive religion is when it comes to its doctrines and dogma, its beliefs. Okay, most religions, with exceptions, they cannot tolerate any sort of opposing thought, contrarian opinions, right? And they most certainly do not approve of somebody pointing out their blatant contradictions. This is the modus operandi of religion, and I'm sorry to say, this is, of course, the way of science as well. Science isn't science anymore. It doesn't seek the truth. Science has become scientism. Okay, scientism. That's a broad difference. I like to call science or scientism quackery, and there are a lot of quacks or hacks in scientism that cannot be trusted, that are suspicious, just like the priest class of any religion. I mean, obviously, right? And therefore, because these institutions that are diametrically opposed but not really, That is why I do not trust these institutions. Okay, they have some good arguments here and there, but mostly they're just, you know, they're just pathetic. Okay. I'm gonna give you a few examples to illustrate just how incredibly similar these two institutions are, these two belief systems, or whatever you want to call it, okay? And then maybe you can conclude for yourself that just as religion, science, or at least a part of it, is just as irrational, okay? So, of course, here is the big example. Religion. Mostly, it's not just Christianity, but we're gonna use Christianity as an example. Of course, there was nothing in the beginning. There was only darkness. And then there was the Word, and then there was the light, and everything came from nothing. Because God willed it, okay? This is Genesis, right? The beginning of all things. There was nothing beforehand, and then all of a sudden, God got bored and he created everything from nothing. Apparently, allegedly, right? And then, of course, you know what I'm trying to get at. Science. The Big Bang Theory. Okay, there was absolutely nothing. There was a big cosmic fart, and then, of course, everything came into being from nothing. I mean, if you can't tell me that this is copy and paste, this is the same idea using different words, okay? This is absolutely the same concept. One uses God and the other uses random chance. I mean, what's the difference, right? It's just so plain, so obvious that even a toddler would notice, right? But since most kids are indoctrinated from the day one, of course they do not have the ability to think for themselves and discern, you know, the similarities and the just, the, what would you call it, the nonsense, basically. You know, you can't prove one or the other, right? It doesn't make any sense, right? From what I understand, and listen, folks, I ain't no scientist, I ain't no religious person, but from what I understand from my research, which is, you know, you can't make something from nothing. It just doesn't make any sense. You are, right now, in the realm of the supernatural, right? So how can science have the balls to claim that there was just this fart from nothing? If there was nothing, then what produced the fart? Because there was nothing, right? Of course, I'm simplifying this, but you get the gist of it, right? This sort of theory, this sort of thinking is more akin to the religious side, right? You know, something came out of nothing, magic, right? Science, everything came from nothing, random chance, right? Tell me, what's the difference? It's the same thing. And these examples are here to illustrate to you that these two structures of belief, these two entities, are more similar than you can even imagine because of their beliefs, theories, or whatever. And also, the way that these two echelons are structured. Okay, they have a hierarchy, they have a priesthood, a priest class. Okay, make no mistake about it. Science is the same as religion when it comes to its structure. Both are stubborn, both refuse to see the possibilities which might reject or contradict their established doctrines and dogmas, right? both throughout the ages have strived to eliminate anybody and anything or any kind of discovery that might pose as a thorn in their beliefs, if you want to call it, or in their theories or their definitions or whatever you want to call it, right? Both religion and science have eliminated people and their discoveries throughout the ages so that the status quo may be preserved. Because if you have established a status quo that, of course, doesn't hold any water, right? That is worthless, basically. But you see, these established doctrines, both religious and scientific, they make a lot of money, okay? They make a lot of money. It makes people feel good. It makes them feel comfortable. And people are willing to pay for these spiritual and scientific, the pills that tickle your fancy, right? When it comes to science, a lot of things nowadays that have been well established that seem almost insurmountable, if you've done any research, they are now being exposed as frauds, as shams, right? Conceived by charlatans to deceive the masses, to keep them dumbed down. Most of the theories and most of the established dogmas or definitions or discoveries of science nowadays seem to be not so insurmountable. They seem to be quite easily deflated with new facts, right? And we all know that religion will not tolerate any opinions that differ, obviously, right? Both priesthoods of religion and science do not want to shake the boat, okay? They want to preserve the status quo, whatever that status quo may be, okay? Especially if it provides profits, okay? So right there and then, you can see why I, for one, do not trust these institutions. To me, there are frauds. They are charades run by charlatans and snake oil salesmen. But that's just me, okay? If you want to, you can believe whatever you want, right? I mean, with religion, there's absolutely no contest whatsoever. You can read any part of the Bible or whatever other religious scripture and, you know, every second line, you can just see the contradiction. You can see the nonsense. It doesn't make any sense, right? Who was there to write, you know, when God decided to create everything out of nothing, right? Who was there taking notes? Who was there when God was creating Eden and Adam and Eve, etc., 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 you see? Who was there? Who wrote this? Who was present? Who was the eyewitness? Who were the usual suspects that were observing this, right? Or did God, after thousands of years, after creating all of this, just appointed a few scribes and said, okay, let me tell you my story, how all of this came to be, right? I mean, just take the Garden of Eden story and the original sin. So Adam and Eve were tricked by the serpent to eat from the apple, and oh boy, right? I mean, who do you think allowed the serpent to enter his garden? Of course it was God, right? God is all-knowing, he's omnipresent, omniscient, omnipotent, right? So God allowed the serpent to trick Adam and Eve, and then God has the balls to waltz into the Garden of Eve and just ask these two, yo, where are you at? Why are you, you know, why are you running away from me, right? Have you by any chance eaten from the apple of, you know, of knowledge, right? Even though he knows that this has happened, he's being coy, he's being bubbly, right? Of course, this fall from grace, this serpent and the apple, it was all orchestrated by God from the beginning, and God has the balls to pretend like he doesn't know what really happened. Of course, he allowed all of this to happen because this was his plan. Anyway, whatever, right? When it comes to science, okay, science in particular tries desperately to numb your mind with so many definitions, so many complicated words, you know, thousands upon thousands of pages of crazy equations and, you know, theories and definitions, just so you just surrender and you accept what they say as fact. And if you read a bit closely, you will surely notice that a lot of what they say is mumbo jumbo, right? It's just hogwash through and through, 100% guaranteed, right? A lot of things that we take for granted, they're all just theories. They have never been proven. No scientist can prove it, right? They don't even try to prove it. They don't even try to disprove it. They just accept it as the status quo because it is profitable. And this is the problem. These two institutions, for the most part, are all about money. Right then and there, you have a major red flag, and that is why I don't trust these people, because they're hypocritical. Hypocritical through and through, okay? And you can keep on going with the examples. You only have to do a bit of research, right? You can't trust what they say. Because if you study who were the figureheads or the ringleaders of both religion and science throughout the centuries and throughout the millennia and what they've done, you know, how they arrived at their discoveries and who backed them financially, etc., 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 man, it's just a roller coaster of deception and deceit and lying. Both of them are conjoined twins, you see. Both of them are siblings. They're twins, okay? And then when you get the state, the government involved, then you have your unholy trinity of just an unholy trinity that strives to keep the masses in total ignorance. They strive to dumb down the population, and they have succeeded swimmingly, fantastically, okay? Because most people are so gullible, so credulous, that they believe anything these people say because they wear a certain garb or a certain, you know, coat, and they just trust these people, right? And then when I make these arguments, people ask me, well, why would these people deceive us, right? Be them priests, scientists, or politicians. Why would they do this? You see, this question alone shows me that you're not intelligent. Your question should be, why wouldn't they? Why wouldn't they do this? Right? When you have a population of dum-dums and drones, of course you're going to take advantage of their stupidity and feed them nonsense. And they're going to pay you for it. Right? I mean, come on, people. Science and religion are the same thing, right? They've always bothered me. When I was a kid, I didn't know why they bothered me. There was just something off about them. And now I know better. I knew that my instincts, my gut instinct, was trying to tell me something. Was trying to tell me the truth. That these institutions and the priests cannot be trusted, and they should be suspected, and they should be called out on their bullshit. Right? I mean, take example for science. You see, in the last couple of decades, or even more, you know, the figureheads of science, you know who they are, right? I mean, what have they discovered, right? To me, a scientist is someone who takes the knowledge, the theorems, the definitions, the hypotheses that already are the body of knowledge, and you strive to elevate them again and again until you arrive at an undeniable certainty. That to me is science. Or if you find something that disagrees with these, with this body of knowledge, then you should expose it for what it is. We were wrong. Here is the new batch of evidence. But they don't do that. Of course they will never do that. Okay? It seems to me, just like the priests of religion, the priests of scientism, their job, their duty is to memorize all of the hogwash, all of the gibberish, the nonsense, and to regurgitate it to the masses that are profane, that are unwashed, that are mindless and unthinking drones. This to me seems to be the job of these priests. Right? They don't seem to disagree. They don't seem to disapprove of any of this. They just take it in and they vomit the same drivel over and over again, generation after generation. So where is this famed progress of thinking? Where is this progress of spirituality? Right? I have never come across a priest of any religion that strives to go in a different direction, that tries to really find, you know, an answer to any of our, you know, intrinsic questions. They just memorize the same thing and they just regurgitate the same hogwash over and over again. There is no difference, in essence, in the basics, in the fundamentals, in the essence of religion and scientism. They're one and the same. They just wear different outfits and costumes, right? And if you have the eyes to see, and the intellect, the mind, to think for yourself, you can see the bullshit. Okay? And as we all know, if you are honest, if you seek the truth, this is my greatest piece of evidence. And tell me if you disagree, but in my view, both religion and scientism, plus the government, which finances both, their highest goal, their singular purpose, has been, from the beginning, to dumb down the population, to make them dumber than a sack of brick, dumber than a sack of bricks, to destroy any type of inquisitiveness, to destroy any kind of creativity, imagination, to destroy any kind of willpower or free will, mostly to destroy one's ability to think critically, to destroy common sense, and of course the result is now that you have a population of dum-dums, of dunderheads that can be easily manipulated and controlled. Okay, so these are the two main purposes or goals of these two or three institutions. To dumb down the population, so that they can be easily controlled like livestock, okay? And there is no way that you can deny this. And you see what I... Another similarity. I've discussed this with priests. I've done so much research, countless videos. Both priests and scientists or quacks, no matter what kind of argument you bring that differs from their convenient status quo, no matter how irrefutable it is, they will automatically defend their stupid bullshit. Even if you show them in a complicated equation that this, what they stand for, is absolutely false, it is a fraud, they would automatically defend their bullshit. You know, priests will be extremely pious, extremely virginal, and puritanical, which I hate this attitude of theirs. And of course, scientists will be extremely arrogant and extremely pompous, right? Right? They're so brainwashed. You see, this is a wonderful irony that both priests and scientists, even though they provide brainwashing for the masses, they themselves have been brainwashed so that they cannot see the truth in your argument, and they cannot see that what they stand for, what they believe in, is utter nonsense. They do not have the ability, they are not competent to discern the contradictions in their own belief system. And that is telling, that the leaders of brainwashing and mind control have been brainwashed and mind controlled themselves to refuse and reject common sense critical thinking because it contradicts their knowledge, right? This is undeniable fact, right? No matter what you tell a priest, he will automatically defend his bullshit. And when it comes to scientists, they won't even listen. The moment you open your mouth and call them out on their bullshit, they immediately snap. They know that what you're trying to say is a big no-no. Okay, so they're so afraid of being contradicted with proof and evidence that are incontrovertible, that they will do anything in their power to label you as a nut, as a lunatic, right? Because of course you do not have a diploma. You do not have a lab coat. You do not have a stethoscope. You do not have a black skirt with a golden cross and a silly little hat. You haven't gone through the indoctrination camps of a certain academy or college. So therefore, no matter how potent and undeniable your argument may be, you'll be made the laughingstock because, of course, in their view, because you do not have their credentials, because you are not licensed like they are, then you are automatically labeled as a uneducated person. You do not know what you're talking about, right? You are not versed in this. You are not able to understand this. Almost as if they're trying to tell you in a subtle way that people who do not belong to their cults, they do not have the right to speak their mind, especially when it contradicts and differs to their own mindsets. You see, you have to have a license, you have to have a diploma, you have to have the right a circus costume, and you have to belong to one of these cults in order to speak your mind on the subject at hand. Okay? These are some of my opinions on the matter. Religion and scientism are exactly the same. Tell me in the comments if you disagree, because unlike these institutions, these cults, I am 100% for free speech. I will never censor anybody. I will never delete anybody's comments. I will never ban anybody from the comment section, because unlike them, I am not so insecure and devoid of confidence that any kind of differing opinion will scare me shitless. You see, I am not like these institutions. Okay, I am not afraid of contradiction. I am not afraid of opinions that differ from my own, as long as they are backed by incontrovertible, irrefutable evidence and proof. Intrinsic. Okay? This is what these institutions are afraid of most of all, because when you start thinking for yourself and you do a bit of research, you will undeniably arrive at the same conclusion that I have arrived. Okay? These institutions, these cults, are not here for our well-being. They do not have our best interests in mind. And worst of all, of course, they are involved with the government in a perverse and obscene and vulgar three-way. A threesome. This is the unholy trinity. Okay? So that's about it. If you want to support your boy, I got a few books on Amazon. Okay? In these books, I tell the truth. The link will be down below. Thanks for watching. See ya. And never forget, think for yourself.